Hello guys, so let's cover the MCQs based on the news and current affairs of today, that is 3rd of December 2016, presented to you by me, Dipanshu Singh. So guys, the general instructions are the same. Do watch the Hindi summary for today, before or after attempting the questions, and then you can pause the video while attempting these questions, and then share your score without fail in the comment section below. And mission 3000 is help us reach this course, the 3000 ratings for this month, so we can make more beneficial courses like these for you guys. So the first question for today is regarding the Comptroller Auditor General of India. Article 148 to 151 deals with the CAG, and CAG can be removed by the President after an inquiry from the Supreme Court, which upholds the ground for removal, and CAG is only responsible to the Parliament. So which of the following is are correct? So the first and the third statement is correct regarding the CAG. The second was is incorrect because the President can remove after a resolution in the Parliament approved by the special majority. So that is why the first and third are only correct. Second is the incorrect option, and it needs a special resolution passed by both the houses of the Parliament with a special majority. And this is in news with the Uttarakhand High Court ordering CAG to conduct a special audit of all the schemes for the Ganga River's rejuvenation financed by the central government. The next question is regarding incorrect regarding the Indian International Science Festival. So it is organized by the Ministry of Science and Technology and Ministry of Earth Sciences in association with VIBA. The fourth India International Science Festival is going to be held soon, and the theme of this year festival is Science for the Masses. And this year it's going to be held at the National Physics Laboratory, Council of Scientific and Industrial Research Institute. Second statement is incorrect because it's not the fourth but the second International Science Festival to be organized. So that is why that statement is incorrect. The next one is regarding the Export Promotion Council of India. So presently there are 14 EPCs, and they come under the administrative control of the Ministry of Finance, and these councils perform both the advisory and executive functions. So which of the following are correct? So there are presently 14 EPCs. This is also correct, and the council performs both advisory and executive functions is also correct. However, it does not come under the Ministry of Finance. It comes under the Department of Commerce, under the Ministry of Commerce and Industry. So that is why second statement is incorrect. A, first and third is the correct option. Next one is regarding the following statements regarding Mercosur. So it is a South American trading bloc. Venezuela was recently removed from Mercosur, and Treaty of Asuncion was the starting point of this agreement. So all the three statements regarding the Mercosur trading bloc is correct, and Venezuela was recently removed from Mercosur, and the Treaty of Asuncion was starting point of this agreement. So D, all of the three statements are correct, and the founding countries of Mercosur and signatories of the Treaty of Asuncion were Argentina, Brazil, Paraguay, and Uruguay. So next question is regarding the market stabilization scheme. So they are issued with the objective of providing the RBI with a stock of securities with which it can intervene in the market for managing liquidity. It was launched in 2015, and these bonds can be used to meet the government expenditure. So which are the following as correct? So apart from first, both of the statements are incorrect. So only the first one is correct, C1 only, because it was not launched in 2015. It was launched in 2004, and it cannot be used to meet the government expenditure. And RBI has said that it has revised the ceiling on issuance of securities under the MSS to this amount from the previous limit of rupees 30,000 crore for financial year of 2016-17, and that is why this was in news. So next one is regarding the following statements for France. So the English Channel separates the UK and France. It shares a border with Netherlands, and Paris lies on the River Danube. So again, only first statement is correct. So C1 only is the correct option because it does not share any border. The English Channel does not share any border with the Netherlands, and Paris lies on the River Seine, not Danube. So that is why this option is also incorrect. And the next question is regarding the public financial management system. So it aims to link the financial networks of central and state governments and the agencies of state governments. And it is administered by the Department of Expenditure. And the platform will allow government expenditure to adapt a just-in-time approach that allows the payments to be made only when they are needed. So all of the three statements are correct. This is given in the today's Hindu's business page news. So all of the three statements are correct, and the standard and the central government will stands to save a significant amount on the interest costs when the public financial management systems is implemented. Okay, the next next question is following graded response action plan associated with. So it is associated with the air pollution in the NCR region. This is based on Supreme Court's directive. So that is why this is in news due to rising level of air pollution in the Delhi and NCR region, and they have notified the graded response action plan with the approval from and drafting from the Central Pollution Control Board, and with in coordination with Sunita Narayan, an environmentalist from the CSE. Next one is regarding the Hornbill Festival associated with which of the following states? Very famous state and very famous festival. Even Prime Minister Modi went, some a few years back, to inaugurate this festival. So C, Nagaland is the correct answer. So it's associated with the Nagaland, and every year it's celebrated in the first week of December. It is one of the biggest indigenous festivals of the country. As well, so the next question is regarding the Vittiya Saksharta Abhiyan. So Vittiya means financial, otherwise in Saksharta means education. So is Visakha aims to create awareness among people about digital economy and cashless modes of transaction. It was launched by Ministry of Finance, and under it, young students and faculty members will be roped to encourage people to use digital transactions. So apart from first and third, the second statement is incorrect. Unlike popular notion, it's not launched by Ministry of Finance, but by Ministry of Human Resource and Development. So that is why second statement being incorrect, A, first and third only are the correct option. And I've already explained you the reason. So this is it for today's questions, guys. Do practice your questions and mention your scores in the comment sections below. Till next video, have a good day and thank you so much.